Hello and welcome to my review of Karlina Von Carstein for Soulblight Gravelords for Warhammer Age of Sigmar from Games Workshop. Now, this is a special miniature. It's a unique Warhammer Plus miniature for subscribers only. There's no way you can pick up this model separately without being a subscriber. Sure, there may be a few people that have either got this model through the subscription or have purchased it as the second miniature for £25 and, you know, for whatever reason, want to sell it on eBay. So if you're not a subscriber to the service, then that's probably the only way you can you'll be able to pick it up without meeting the criteria. There are two miniatures. I'll put the Imperial Guard unbroken or whatever it is on the, you know, right side of the screen now. So that's your second choice. So you can pick either one, and then you've got the option of you know, paying for the other one. I currently can't buy the Orc one, which was only last year's Warhammer Plus secondary miniature. So what that means is I'm pretty sure that you can get the second miniature throughout your subscription until it renews, and then you don't get that facility. So I can't pick up that Orc miniature from last year anymore. But at the moment I can pick up Unbroken. I think £25 is a fair amount of money though for a single Imperial Guard model, KDM model, but I also think £25 is a lot for this, really. I think £25, not too bad for the Assassin, because, you know, that's quite a big model, big base and everything. I'm not a big fan of these two models. I think they're the worst two models out of the 3 years we've had, I think, just about. But, you know, your opinion on that may vary. Anyway, let's review this model. As always, I'll look at the miniature, go through how easy she was to build, go through the spare parts, which there is one spare part. Then I'll go through all of the rules. Now, I think I've got third edition Soulblight rules, so that's what I will be using for her. I think they're still valid, I think. But yeah, I'll be using those rules. So let's have a look at the miniature up close. She's a nice miniature, a good vampire lord if you wanted to use her as that. Very easy and quick to build and put together. You know, you get a little bit of a scenic kind of skull with a stake through the head, which is quite, yeah, pertinent. She's got this chalice, I guess it's got blood in it probably, or it had blood. She's got this sword. She's got this helmet, of which I think is most likely hair armor. Her armor's pretty good. The cloak is very nice as well. It's just, yeah, nice vampire lord model. Not, you know, overly impressive or anything. You know, you could expect to see this being sold individually. But yeah, that's the miniature. Straightforward to put together. Nice amount of detail. This is the spare part. I'll show you this close up, I guess. It's just a helmetless head, and that's why for me it looks like she's got hair armor, because the armor for her head is in the sort of same shape as her hair. But you know, obviously it is the same person. So yeah, you can go for a helmetless one. I just went for a helmeted one though. But there you go, that's the spare part. Okay, so some size comparisons then. I just want to show you Karlina's size compared to other Soulblight Gravelords miniatures. And I don't think I really did any reviews of Soulblight, so I'll try and get them done, probably in some kind of quiet period of the channel, but better late than never, I guess. So the first model I'll compare her with is with the Vampire Lord, which I think you can get separately now. On the same size base, you know, the Terminator 40mm base, the OG kind of Vampire Lord looks taller because she's on this kind of quite pointy tactical rock. It's got this mace as well. It's got the shield and a load of bats flying from her hair. So yeah, that's the vampire lord. I'm not sure. I mean, I'd probably say Karlina looks a bit more, you know, sort of grim dark, rather than like, you know, these cartoony kind of bats flying from the hair. But I still think the OG vampire lord is quite cool. There just seems to be more detail on Karlina, you know, with the armor plates, the rivets, things like that. This seems more of a quite, dare I say it, a kind of basic model. But yeah, because I would expect more and more detail on the armor plates and also that mace, where there's loads of detail just on the chalice and the blade. But anyway, that's where they both measure up. Similar kind of size compared to other infantry sort of models. So here's one of the death rattle skeleton warriors. So taller than one of those, taller than the dreadwalker zombies. Here's one of the direwolves. So yeah, her with a pack of them. I mean, direwolves are pretty big. Look how big they are, you know. They're a bit bigger than her lengthwise. Maybe she can have a pet. And then compared to one of the blood knights that seems to be on a bit of a wonk maybe, but yeah, as compared to one of these. And then compared to my usual sort of miniatures that I like to compare sizes with, the 40k ones. If you are, you know, collecting 40k, you probably watched a lot of the 40k videos the past 2 weeks. We've got a normal space marine, so she's, you know, a fair bit taller than a normal space marine. That means that she's going to be taller than Slimarbo. And then next to a Primaris, she's actually taller than a Primaris. So yeah, quite a tall mini. Then again, the OG vampire lord on the tactical rock was taller than him. So yeah, quite a tall mini in the grand scheme of things compared to other infantry. Okay, so what I'll do now is just go through her rules, and I'll use the normal sort of third edition rules from the Soulblight Gravelords battle tome. She doesn't get any specific, you know, named character rules, which is a bit of a shame, but there we go. So the rules I'll be using are just when you call her a vampire lord. A vampire lord is a leader model and will cost you 140 points. Her stat line reads movement of 6 inches, save of 3 plus, bravery 10 and 5 wounds. It's quite decent, you know, especially that 3 plus save. The vampire lord is a single model armed with soul bound blades, and this model can fly. Remember that. The soul bound blades, it's a range of 1 inch, 4 attacks, 3 plus to hit, 3 plus to wound, rend minus 1, damage d3. That's pretty good. Abilities, the hunger. At the end of the combat phase, if any enemy models were slain by wounds inflicted by this model's attacks in that phase, you can heal up to d3 wounds allocated to this model. Pretty nice, I like that. You know, probability, you're always going to be getting, you know, half your wounds back, kind of, with the two. Magic, this model is a wizard. It can attempt to cast one spell in your hero phase and attempt to unbind one spell in the enemy hero phase. It knows the Arcane Bolt and Mystic Shield spells. Command abilities, Crimson Feast. You can use this command ability in the combat phase. If you do so, pick one friendly Soulblight Gravelord's summonable unit wholly within 12 inches of this model. Add one to the attacks characteristic of that unit's melee weapons until your next hero phase. The same unit cannot benefit from this command ability more than once per phase. So that's pretty good. You know, you get a Soulblight Gravelord's summonable unit, which of course includes those Deadwalker zombies, Black Knights, Grave Guard, and Deathrattle skeletons. Oh, as well as Direwolves and Fell Bats. So that's a nice little bonus as well. Keywords, Death, Vampire, Soulblight Gravelords, Hero, Wizard, Vampire Lord. So there you go, quite a short review of Karlina, probably because she doesn't have her own, you know, unique character abilities and things. But if you don't already have that awesome looking vampire lord, you know, with the shield and the bats and things, and you're after another one, or maybe you're just after another vampire lord for your army, this is quite a nice choice to have. What do you guys think of Karlina Von Carstein, and also the other Warhammer Plus miniature this year? I'm still not sure whether I'll pick it up. If you think I should, obviously, you know, please do put your thoughts and opinions down below. Thank you for joining me today. Thank you for watching. Blood for the Blood God.